if a charging station is under repair, it basically suffocates all the bikes around it from charging from there. Recently, when I was riding my Ather 450X on low charge, the bike died on the way. I had to walk my bike for about 700 meters to a charging station. This experience had shown me a few problems that the Ather fast charging network itself has. Let's talk about these for this video today. By the way, if you have not watched this video, I'd recommend you to do that. There is a timeline that we had curated talking about the 5 problems of this video. Please feel free to use that timeline to watch whichever section you want. So let's start. Number of charging points present per each charging station. You see, if you are in Bangalore, your app shows you that there are around 35 to 40 charging stations across the city. But the problem is, most of the charging stations have only one charging point. Now this is fine, but the problem comes when you reach the charger point with low charge and there is some other bike plugged in left at the charging point and you can't unplug the charger, which means you are literally waiting over there for the availability of charging point till that person comes to unplug his bike. Or let's take for example, the person is present. If there is a single point charger, I have to wait at least for 45 minutes for his bike to get charged till I get a plug point for me to charge my bike. Now with increasing electric bikes across the city, particularly Ather, having a single charger point at each charging station, I don't think it makes sense anymore. As per my experience, every time I go to a charging point, it's either plugged in by someone else or it's either not serviceable, particularly in this locality where I live in. Now the problem comes because of the single charging point. Ather, if you are watching this, why don't you put a second charging point for each charging station? It helps us a lot. It is required. Single charger point per each station really sucks. I think I know the reason for that. Why do we have one charging point at each of the charging station? Let's talk about that in the second point now. Lack of visibility about the demand for the charging points. Let's talk for example, you have an Ather and you are low on charge and you drove to a charging point right nearby to you, and by the time you went there, there were 2 people waiting for the charging. Now you are the 3rd person waiting in the line, which means you are supposed to wait for close to 1.5 to 2 hours for the charging point. Now how does Ather know that you 2 people are waiting for the charger? Because there is no way you can let them know that you are waiting. So they won't know that you are waiting at the charging point unless they track your live location of your bike, which I think they will not do because it's your privacy thing. They can't track your live location about something. So there is literally no way they can know about the increase in demand of the fast charger. So when there is no visibility, there is no need for them to add fast chargers. So dear Ather, think about that. Now third point, visibility of status at the charging station. Okay, let's take the same example as we talked before. You have an electric bike and you're low on charge and you search on the Ather app about the charger nearby. It shows that it is busy, but you don't know when will it be free. What if that bike plugged in over there, because of which it is showing busy? What if that bike has close to 95% of charge while you are at 5% of charge and you can't drive to any other charging station? Now this visibility is not available on the app. See, I can understand that you can't show the person information on the app, but if you can show the charging percentage of the bike that is currently plugged in to the charging point, it immensely improves the experience of the fast charging network. And this way, I have a clear idea about when to go to a charger. I need not go to a charger, figure out that the bike has just plugged in and I got to wait there for an hour or something. So having this visibility on the app about the charging status of the bike which is plugged in currently greatly adds value to the app. And the next point, functioning of the fast charger is not proper. If you have not seen this short that I had recently posted, please do watch that. The problem that I talk over there is that the Ather fast charger, after plugging into my bike, even though the app shows my bike is charging, the dashboard shows it is charging on my bike, but in reality the bike is not getting charged. If you can see the projected range, which is a direct measure of the charging of my bike, it falls all the way to the current charge that I have, which means even though the dashboard and the app are showing it is charging, my bike is not being charged. This charger is faulty, which is not picked up by the app yet. And the charger itself shows active. The green color on the charger, it shows active. If it is under service, it goes to red or orange. If it's green, it means it's working. So neither the charger has picked it up that it is not working, neither the app has picked it up, and hence the repair of charger is not happening. Of course, there was a recent update about this, that you can report the charging point issues through the Ather app. That's a good touch to the app, which can give us the freedom to let you know that this charger is not working. But if there were two charges or three charges, these problems can be easily understood and easily rectified. And first of all, the customers, we can have the immense pleasure of riding the bikes. So these are my thoughts about the problems of fast charging network of Ather. What are your thoughts? Please do let us know in the comments below.